My name's Mayor McArthur. I'm an Asian art curator, writer, and educator. Robert, to me, really personifies the spirit of the origami world. He is a brilliant scientist. He trained as an engineer and a physicist and worked for JPL for many years and has done a lot of research with a whole range of scientists in the medical world and space exploration world. He's also a very gifted artist who's able to create sculptures that really, they seem to breathe. They're so lifelike and beautiful. He's also an incredibly generous individual, and it was incredibly helpful to me introducing me to artists in the origami world, but also helping out when I needed pieces for the exhibition that I couldn't get. He lent pieces from his own personal collection. He's also an incredible communicator. I haven't heard anybody explain the world of origami better than Robert does. And it's a complicated world, but he does it in a very clear, accessible manner, which I think is a real gift. One of the aspects of Robert's work that I enjoy is that he has a real gift for creating very realistic depictions of animals and birds and insects. And he has created the types of creatures that you see here in California, like the red-tailed hawk. He's also folded rattlesnakes out of a single square of paper, and those are breathtaking. Armadillos, a lot of the mooses, a lot of the creatures that you find that are native to the United States. And he's clearly studied them extremely well, but he's understood them, their essence, so that he's not just created the form of the creature, but often you get the sense of the creature itself and its spirit. And in his red-tailed hawk, which I've exhibited in the folding paper exhibition, you really get a sense of that, the majesty of the hawk as it soars above your head. And there's a real sense of that he captures the spirit, the essence of the creatures he folds. One of the things that I find so fascinating about the origami world is that creating a design out of origami is a very individual process. In many ways, it's a very intense process. Many of the folders, the designers who I've met over the years, they can spend hours and weeks, days and weeks, folding an object. It's a very intense sort of personal process. But at the same time, the origami world is a world that connects people, brings people together. And I saw this very well at one of the Origami USA conventions, where 600 plus people were gathered to share the designs and to teach each other how to fold. It's one of the most open, most generous communities that I've experienced in the art world. And so, in a way, the folding of a form out of paper is a very intensely personal experience. It's your eyes, your hands, you're concentrated on it for hours on end. But at the same time, it can bring people together. And perhaps one of the things that is important about this play is that it shows how that very intense experience can unite people, bring people together, so it sort of connects their hearts, their stories are connected through folding paper. Sure. So one of the most amazing scientific applications of Robert's that I've seen is his development of a prototype of a space telescope. He was working with Lawrence Livermore Laboratory several years back, developing a space telescope that was supposed to expand in space. The lens was supposed to expand to a diameter of 100 meters, the length of a football field. The prototype that he worked on had a diameter of 5 meters, and his mission was to create a folding pattern for a lens that would be made in glass, and in fact the prototype was built out of glass. It was to be folded small enough so that it could be deployed, sent up into space, and then it would open out in space. And he did indeed develop that prototype. He figured out a folding pattern that actually worked for a glass telescope lens. He's also worked with airbag manufacturers to figure out an algorithm that would enable them to tell how their airbags would deploy in a crash. A very, very complicated process. He's also worked in the realm of medicine, helping to develop cradles for the heart, for heart surgery, using folding techniques. He's also working, I believe, currently with Caltech scientists to figure out how to help people see people who are unable to see, they are developing some sort of a camera and a sensor, and he is developing a component that can be folded and inserted into the eye to send a signal to the brain to tell the person what they're looking at using origami. And if that doesn't blow your mind, I don't know what.